So today I got a little surprise in my mailbox, and I got these lovely weights from Wellbeing, which I love because they're so different to the normal dumbbells. They have a really nice kind of grip to it, and they're a little bit heavier than what I've got in the studio. So I'm going to try them out and see how they feel. I'll just bend off. Right, so let's do a little Pilates with some extra weights. It's good for our bone density, it's good for all over well health, and it's a little bit different probably to the normal Pilates routine we do. Alright, so we start understanding, let our arms just hang, and just move the shoulders slightly backwards. Just feel the shoulders, notice the scapulas, how they move up and down as you lift the shoulders, leave your arms hanging, and start lifting the elbow as well. Good. And then from here, let's just soften the knees a little bit. I'll show you from the sides, hinge slightly forwards from the hip. Lift one arm. So really important here is to keep the head in line with the rest of your spine, not feel there with your chin. Alright? Feel the shoulder blades, notice how the arm, how the shoulders are supporting the arm in the lift. For 4, 3, 2, and 1. Good. And then stand back upright, notice your shoulders, spiral your arms slightly out, bend your elbows. Again, soften the knees a little bit, and then start rotating the arm inwards and outwardly. Really feel the humerus, the arm bone, spiraling in your shoulder joint. It's really good if you have a frozen shoulder or you're a bit tight around your chest. Scapula really keeps the pecs wide open as you rotate out. And then as you rotate in, you feel the scalar bone rotating and spiraling as well. Good, for 4, you can feel the scapulas at the back widening just along the rib cage. It's lovely, it's a really good movement just for the shoulders. You can do it even without weights. For 4, 3, 2, and 1. And then let your arms hang. Good, so now shake your legs. Let's include our legs a little bit, bounce a little bit on the spot. And then again, place your feet hip width, and I'm sure you get for the side, and then soften the knees, hinge forward from the hips, keep your arms long, push through the heel back up, and roll your shoulders back. Soften and roll your shoulders back. Again, keep the head in line with the rest of your spine. 4 more, and 3, and 2. And 1, and then please stay here. Push the elbow back, and elbow back, and hold. For 4, and 3, and 2, and 1. Now stay here and pulse. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And then please come back up. Lift your heels, please. Draw the inner thighs in and up, roll through your ankle, and as you roll through your ankle, swing the opposite arm up all the way into shoulder flexion. Whoops. Exhale as you send the arms up. Go 4, 3, and 2. And again, notice the shoulder blades gliding at the back. One more other side. And stay here. Both arms. Soften the elbow. Bring the elbow slightly forwards and push up. And again, soften the elbows and push up. Soften the elbow and breathe out. Make sure your center is engaging, so ribs and pelvis are connecting, because it's better and stronger. You are in the center and your trunk is easier. It's for your shoulders to move efficiently. For 4, and 3, and 2, and 1. And then soften your knees. Sorry, soften your elbows and come down. Good, shake your legs again. And then slowly place your left leg back, both feet are pointing forwards, right? Gaze is ahead, we're adding a little bit of lunges to our movement. So soften the elbow, sorry, soften the knees, come up, send the elbows up, arms forward and down, and go back down into a lunge. When you go into a lunge, could you make sure that you use both legs? So you're not meant to hinge forward like this. You're meant to go like a lift, down, straight down and up. Straight down and up. Breathe out as the load is coming up here. For four, three, two, and one. And hold. Four, three, two, one, and bring your arm down. Good. Check your legs, and let's do the other side. Step back. What I really like is that my front foot slightly comes in, because when I bend my knee, my knee goes slightly in, so it kind of keeps it in line. So we're starting again, just with a straight lunge, straight down and up, like this. Okay. Now we're adding arm differently. Come up and lift. And come down and go up into abduction. Good, what you want here again, strong center. Breathe out as you lift. I can see my hands and my weight in my peripheral view. And I think that's really important. So we're not just going here, okay? So if we keep the hands slightly in our peripheral view, it's easier for our core to stay connected. So the ribs connecting with your pelvis. For four, and three, and two, and one, and up. And then please step back forwards, shake your leg, bounce a little bit. Good. Here we go down to the floor now. So please come to the end of your mat. Breathe out, heads roll down, let your arms hang. Use the weight to just let the back line lengthen and stretch. Breathe, long arms, head in between your arms. Make sure you let your head hang. And push the floor away with your feet. Roll back out, relax your shoulders. Gaze back. And one more time. Down, 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 down. Let hip, neck and shoulder hang. And then push back up. Last one. And then please from here, just come into crouch position. There you go. Okay? So now we're gonna sit down. Our feet have to come slightly forwards to the end of the mat. Knees to the ceiling. Again, weight on your hands, elbows are close to your hips. And I'd like you to start rolling off your sit bone, nice and soft. Breathing out, come back. Make sure as you roll back that your feet are initiating that slow articulation in your lumbar spine. Good, and come back. So we are adding now, obviously, a little bit more weight to this as we go up. Arms soften and arms forward. Good for four and three and two. And then please soften the elbows, bring the weights to the floor, stretch your legs out, bring your arms forward, see if you could sit upright. If not, please bend your knee and just stretch forward. Notice how light your arms are. Exhale, roll back up, lift through the sit bones and open your arms. Good, I'm gonna lie back now, one weight. We only need one weight here. Yeah? Stay here. Gaze up to the ceiling. ceiling, arms up, legs into tabletop. Just take my hand up. There we go. Now, make sure the knees are in line with the hips, arms up. Breathe out as you send one leg out as well as both arms. Breathe out. Really strong in your center. Keep ribs and pelvis connected, meaning try to avoid lifting that belly up or bulging. And if it's too much, just to decrease your range, just stay here. Okay? If you find really strong in your spine, kind of starts to wobble, just move, decrease your range of motion. Otherwise, go all the way. One more time. And then stay here, place the weight just between your knees, keep hold of it. Arms up. And move both arms and legs slightly away from the center. Again, strong impact. Breathing out will support and facilitate your core stability. If this is too much, bring your arms down. Just move here. Okay, keep hold. Whoopsie. Slip. And two more. And one more. And please hold. Take the weight again. Arms up to the ceiling. Last one. Elbow to the chest. And breathe out. Elbow to the chest. And breathe out as you push up. Keep the knees in tabletop if this is too much. Place your feet to the floor. Makes it a little easier on the core. For four. And three, two, and one. Now keep the arms long. Breathe out through head, neck, and shoulder. Hold, and then stretch your legs out. And roll all the way up. Hold and lengthen. Now this is so nice with the weights. You can literally hold them really easy in both hands. Unfold, long back. Inhale and exhale. So I facilitate again your movement with the exhale as you roll up. That's it. Four more. Three more. Good. And then just take one weight again. Take the weight just in front of your chest and roll up. And send your arms up. Roll off, send your elbow close to your body, to the chest, and roll back. Keep going. I'm just going to sort my hair out. Keep going. Just roll down. Keep the weight close to your chest. Roll back up. Last few minutes, okay? Down and up. And up. For four. Keep going, come on. You can do this. For three. And one. Well done. Stay here, weights to the side. Your feet just in front of you. Roll your shoulders. If you sit uncomfortable, please sit on a little pillow or just something that lifts you. Arms to the side. Stretch up. And just lengthen over to your left. Breathing into the side. back up. Other side, lengthen. And reach up and over. Inhale, just to lengthen the side a little bit more and the intercostals to open. And come back up. Good. Now left arm up, right arm up to the ceiling. Follow your arm to the back. So meet your arm back. Other side, arm up. Follow your arm with your gaze. Position and then stand up. Shake your legs, bounce a little bit, shake your arms. Let's do this for a little bit longer. Notice the elasticity in your body, a little bit of a bounce through the foot, nice and soft landing. And now fit it, be a little bit jelly. My dog is looking at me just over there. You know, she's loud. Shake, 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 shake. Well done. Place your feet at width. Your arms hang off the sides of your body and close your eyes for a moment. Notice the way you're standing. And notice your breath. Notice how fast or slow your breath is. See if you could elongate the outwards breath. And then open your eyes again. Well done. Thank you very much for joining.